When declaring a pass action, you can move your player and after that throw the football. Note that unlike a blitz action, your move ends as soon as you make the pass. Only one player on your team can actually declare a pass action, so only one player may move and then throw the football. The movement part of any action follows all normal movement guidelines, so you have to make dodge rolls if needed, and also you are able to pick up the ball. So in this case it would be possible for my thrower to move over to the ball, pick it up, continue his movement and then pass the ball to this catcher over here. As the thrower's movement is 6, he would move over here for 1, 2, pick up the ball, say he succeeds, 3, 4, 5, 6 to move to this player. When throwing the football you need to determine range first. For that you take the range ruler. As you can see, it has different types of ranges: quick pass, short pass, long pass, or if you're feeling very lucky you could try a long bomb. You have a circle at the end, place that over the thrower and then look where the target square end up. In this case, if I would be passing to this human catcher over here, I would throw a quick pass. If a player is on the border of 2 different range categories, you always pick the highest category. So for instance, if this catcher would be on the border of quick pass and short pass, it will have to be a short pass. It is also possible to target empty squares, but not very sensible, but the rules state it is possible. Having determined the range of our throw, it's now time to see whether that throw will land on target. For that you need to know the player's agility. In this case my thrower has an agility of 3, which will give me a basic result of 4 plus needed for success. But as with most agility rolls, there are of course modifiers, in this case the passing modifiers, and you see they are range base. Throwing a quick pass will give you a +1, and this will get harder the further you try to throw the ball. Throwing a long bomb, for instance, would give you a -2 modifier on your roll. Also, as with most agility rolls, per enemy tackle zone on the player throwing the ball will give you a -1 result. Now, as with all agility rolls, you roll a d6 to determine the result. If it's equal or higher than the result needed, the ball is on target and will land in the target square. In this case, it would be in the hands of my catcher, or at least he could try to catch it. If the ball isn't on target, then it scatters 3 times before it lands. Scattering is again by rolling the 8-sided die and looking up the result on the scatter template. So, for instance, in this case my ball wouldn't be on target. You scatter the ball 3 squares from the target square. So I get a result of 6, would be this square. A result of 8 would mean this square. And a result of 1 would mean it would land in this square. Note that if the ball crosses any other players during the 3 scatters, only the last scatter is where the ball ends up. So it can't be caught in between the other scatters. And as normal, if the ball ends up in an empty square, that's where it will land and bounce 1 more square. And bouncing, as described earlier, is again scattering the ball 1 square. In this case, to square 8, which will be over here. And that's the ball where the ball will lie still. In this case, it isn't caught by a player on your team, which means this will be a turnover. As you roll 3 times, it is even possible for the ball to end up in its original target square. So the player can still try to catch it, although this will be a little bit harder than trying to catch an accurate pass. Now, if you roll a 1 before modification or a 1 after modification, you actually manage to fumble the ball. As your throw is so poor, you actually let it slip from your hands. In this case, the ball will simply bounce 1 square from where you're standing. So you roll a scatter die, I roll a 3, so the ball will end up over here. If a player of my team would be standing there and actually caught the ball by accident, well, you wouldn't have a turnover, but otherwise, if the ball ends up on an empty square, your turn is ended. Let's take a look at the throw again and now make sure the ball is on target, for instance with this 5 over here. In this case, the catcher has the opportunity to catch the ball. Now, catching again is an agility roll. A catcher has a basic agility value of 3, which would give you a 4 plus needed in order to catch the ball. But it is a lot easier to catch now, because it is an accurate pass, which will give me a plus one modifier. Again, as with almost any agility roll, enemy tackle zones give you a minus one per tackle zone. In this case, there are no tackle zones. The pass is accurate, because this would give me a 3 plus needed. In this case, I failed to catch the ball, which means the ball will scatter one square away from me. Square 2. There it will keep still, and unfortunately my turn is ended because the ball wasn't caught by a player on my own team. Would I have rolled a 3 or higher, I would have caught the ball with this player. Now if this player still had to act, it could move away with the ball. One final note I'd like to add about passing is that if the ball is caught by a player on your team which wasn't the intended target, say for instance you try to reach this catcher over here, but the ball scatters to this lineman, and he actually managed to catch the ball, it isn't a turnover, as the ball is caught by one of your players. So it doesn't have to be the target that catches this, it would be convenient, but it doesn't have to. But if another player catches it, at least you get to finish your turn. Performing a handoff is very similar to passing, although in this case you move your player and then try to give the ball to an adjacent player instead of throwing it to one further away. It is possible to give the ball to an opponent as well, you don't just have to select your own players, but I think that would be highly inadvisable. Now as with passing, you first take the movement part of your action and then perform the action, namely the handoff. If you have any movement points unspent, those can't be used anymore this turn. Unlike passing, you don't need to check whether your ball is on target or not. It's always counted as an accurate pass, so the only thing you need to do when trying to perform a handoff is actually catch an accurate pass. In the example I've set up over here, my human lineman, who has a movement value of 6, will try to hand off the ball to this human catcher. I can move 1, 2, 3, 4, and now I'm adjacent, so I can hand off the ball to the catcher. Like I said, you only need to catch an accurate pass, which in this case will be 4 plus basic plus 1 for accurate, so I need a result 3 plus. I roll a 6, no problem at all. My catcher catches the ball and the action is ended, and I can continue my team's turn. Now if you don't manage to catch the ball, like in passing, you will scatter the ball one square. In this case I roll a 5, which would mean it would bounce one square further on. And the turn is ended because it isn't caught by a player on my own side. Notice if another player of my team would be on this square and he would catch the ball, you can still continue your turn.